plus five, not a rocket science. This day and time, that's hard to find. It's true. The road we're on in a traffic jam.
Hi, I'm Dr. Paula Hill Collins. I am the clinical director here at the Health Wagon. I came to the Health Wagon in 2009. However, I have known Sister Bernie Keeney, our founder, since I was in college. Sister Bernie Keeney came here in 1980 with a flaming red hair and a Massachusetts accent. And with our twang, she still fit right in. She is a hero to our community. I say she was an innovative leader of the country because the model that she began all those years ago, a mobile health care given by a nurse practitioner, could be replicated across the nation. We remain a nurse managed clinic today.
Stan Brock, the founder of Remote Area Medical, actually came to this area, met with Sister Bernie Keeney and Dr. Teresa Tyson, and they're all three co-founders of Remote Area Medical and WISE. Typically, RAM headquarters had an international presence, but they saw a need here in Southwest Virginia. So they came to WISE Virginia, and now we have the largest health outreach of its kind in the nation. Typically, 1,500 volunteers come to the RAM project, and they service over 3,000 patients.
Ain't no need to complicate it. We both know that's overrated. We've been there, it's safe to say it ain't our style. Yeah, it's like 1, 2, 3, just as easy as can be. Just the way you look at me, you make me smile.
With respect to Medicaid in Virginia, following the Affordable Care Act, each state made a decision about whether it would take advantage of an opportunity to expand Medicaid. For many years, Virginia thought that it wasn't worth it, the idea of taking federal money, which is an enhanced federal funding for states that decided to expand Medicaid. That fact, plus here in Wise County, Virginia, which is in Appalachia, the very corner of southwestern Virginia, where Virginia meets Kentucky and Tennessee. This is Appalachia, this is coal country, and for years it relied on the coal industry. With the decline in coal, both for the market for coal and the availability of coal to mine, people that live here have been doing a lot of jobs like construction, logging, things like that. And a lot of the places that they work don't provide health coverage. Not having health coverage, whether through a commercial employer or through Medicaid, is one of the things that sort of keeps funding for the healthcare infrastructure very sparse here. So the Health Wagon stepped in a number of years ago and has been doing kind of mobile clinics in the broader area to provide primary care to people. They teamed up with RAM, Remote Area Medical, a number of years ago to begin doing these clinics. This is the fifth year that I've been coming. They've been going a lot longer than that. It clearly fills a need. Once a year, people have availability to an influx of specialist physicians, endocrinology, orthopedics, cardiology, plastic surgery, dermatology, and so on, as well as an opportunity to get glasses, which are furnished by the Lions Club, both frames and lenses. Lions bring a lens grinding truck here. I've heard they turn out about 600 pairs of glasses over just a few days. One of the reasons that I keep coming back is the ability to help people, to contribute something. And reminds me that my problems are very simple.
I started coming to Appalachia about 15 years ago as a chaperone on youth trips to repair homes, and did that for 10 years. And for the last 4 or 5 years, I've come to RAM. And I find it very touching since I have no skills as a doctor or nurse, I can come here and help set up tents, clean up and help prepare so that people who desperately need help can get it on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
I have been coming to RAM for now 5 years. My training is in family medicine. And so in years past, I've worked in the general medical area, but my main job now is doing wound care. So for the Department of Surgery at my home base, Carilion Clinic in Roanoke. So I brought my team with me today, and we're going to be taking care of people's wounds of all sorts, including diabetic foot ulcers, stasis ulcers, non-healing surgical wounds, basically any kind. And my reason for being here is that I feel that healthcare is a basic human right. And so when there is lack of access, I like it when people put together the resources and find a way to solve that. And so this event is one of the best examples of that in the Southwest Virginia area. So I'm proud to be a part of it again this year.
Okay, my name is David Harris. I'm from Detroit, Michigan. Came down here to bring my daughter to this so she can get her medical stuff taken care of. She needs some dental work and glasses. You know, unfortunately, she can't afford the insurance to cover it. So this is another great thing for her. She's over at the school right now getting some major stuff done for her teeth. And she just got her glasses yesterday. Great job and everything.
My name's Franny. I'm 41 years old. I've had triple bypass open heart surgery. Without RAM, it would be totally different.
I know it.
Thank God and everyone here and the people and volunteers and physicians. I'm overwhelmed with their gratitude and very thankful. I had an echogram, a mammogram. I see women's health, diabetes specialist, ultrasound. I'm due to have gallbladder surgery removal. They also found a cyst today that they probably would have not found because I'm underinsured. Don't have insurance. So thankful to them, I'm able to get things done with follow-ups and the physicians and the volunteers. Thank you.
My name is John Hempel. I came out here today to have a hearing test done. They found out that I had severe deafness. They made molds a day for hearing aids. They helped me. If it wasn't for RAM, a lot of these folks here, including myself, would be lost. It's a blessing from the Lord. That was my wife you seen with the waterfalls a couple minutes ago. It's just a great place and a great blessing. I mean, I'm thankful to God, and I'm thankful to all the volunteers here, including the one filming this, and all the doctors and everybody else here, the nurses and all. Man, there's a lot of people here that benefit from this. It's really a great program, and it's a blessing, like I said. Thank you. Y'all have a blessed day.
Forget the keys under the mat. When childhood stars shine, always stay humble and kind. Go to church cause your mama says to. Visit grandpa every chance that you can. It won't be wasted time, always stay